I want to welcome you all. I'm way down here because I realize that you all are having such a good time, which is the whole point, that that you're noisy, and so I needed a mic. But I would love to have your attention. This evening is, I can hear some folks. I will. This evening is called The Passion for Preservation. Thank you. If you can come down this way, it would be really wonderful so you could hear and see. This evening is called The Passion for Preservation, and thanks to the TDC and to our partners, the city, Main Street, and this wonderful, the city and Main Street provided this space, and they are our partners. The Historical Society, of course, Trinity Church, Friends of Trinity Church, and am I forgetting a partner? I feel like I am forgetting a partner. The Chamber of Commerce, thank you. And Anita, who is very, very important. So, to my friends and partners, thank you. I want to tell you Martha Harris, so if Martha comes up, she was the one that I thought it would be great if we had a symposium like they do in Newport, Rhode Island, but ours would be better someday. And so Martha thought that was a great idea. She has faith, I think, because she wrote the grant. The TDC believed in us, and they gave us quite a bit of money, which was wonderful. And then here we are tonight, the opening of our first annual symposium, and this is entitled The Passion for Preservation. So welcome, and thank you for having faith in us. And thank you, Martha. Yeah. So we have some awards to give out. I didn't plan to stand up here and talk all night long, and thank goodness. And I want to have Mr. Willoughby Marshall introduce our first person who is going to give an award. So Willoughby, watch out for the cords.
Deb, you want to come up? We have with us, very fortunately, Dr. James Cusick, who is curator of the P.K. Young University of Florida Library of History. And they were good enough to take the city's map, the 1834 map of Apalachicola, which was becoming very deteriorated because it's very old. And they have restored the map to a new-looking condition, beautiful. And Dr. Cusick has brought a copy of it here today for the city, and I think that right now the idea is that the map would be on long-term loan to the University of Florida, and that the city would be provided with a copy of it and with a disc that it could make more copies if it needed them. And so it's a great thing to, I think, to have saved that. And so,
John?
You want me to use?
Yes, use the mic.
What? We may have lost the mic. Okay. Well, first of all, I'd like to thank you all for inviting me over here to make the presentation for the map. This is a beautiful city, and certainly you should preserve every inch of it. I mean, it's really incredible when you come across that bridge. To see what's here. It's just amazing. I can't take a lot of credit for this. Actually, there were two emeritus professors in preservation at the University of Florida who talked to Mr. Marshall and who took, when the map came to the university, we gave it to our paper conservator and he cleaned it up and made sure that it was not in any danger. We're glad to have it on loan from the city, although anytime the city needs the original back, we'll, you know, since it is on loan, we'll be glad to return it here. But since the original is probably too valuable and too fragile to put on display, we made a replica of it, a full-size replica, which we have framed, which I'm going to unveil in a moment for the mayor. And I would encourage you to take a look at it, because it's a beautiful print map, but it also has all sorts of notes in pen on it. About the town, So it's very interesting to look at. It's a very interesting part of your heritage. And as you move forward in preservation too, I work a lot with the city of St. Augustine and other places. And actually, when you're trying to make a case for historic preservation of your town, often in addition to any buildings and legacies you have, the fact that you've preserved your original town plan, or that people can walk around and see the streets as they were 100 years ago, is often very important in making that case. And it's also a big attraction for people. People in Pensacola and St. Augustine, other places, love the fact that they can take a map from the 1800s or the 1700s and can actually walk around town with it. And you can do that with this map, too. So without further ado, for Mayor Johnson, I'd like to maybe jointly unveil the map, I guess, and everybody can have a look at it.
So we will have the map on display, and Mayor Johnson, did you want to say anything, or? I would hope so.
I'll keep it brief. This is a wonderful occasion and a wonderful addition. This is perhaps one of our most prized possession and map of the city of Apalachicola from 1834. It's something we all can be proud of. I'm just truly grateful. Thank you, Mr. Marshall.
Thank you.
And one of our partners, the Historical Society, is going to give out two new awards. And I'll let Tom, the president of the Historical Society, tell you about the awards.
Thank you. Everybody can hear? All right. We really know what this event is about. Everybody's had to be quiet, but I realize that y'all are here because today is my 60th birthday, and I appreciate it. Surprise party! Thank you. Thank you so much. And if you forgot your gifts, cash, check, jewelry, whatever, it's just fine. No, thank you. We're here to talk about preservation and the wonderful things that are happening in this community. I grew up here, and when I came back 5 or 6 years ago, it was just like this town had transformed itself. I mean, when I grew up here, there was hardly a house with paint on it, let alone a preserved structure. It really is phenomenal, and that's 30, 40 years, and we think about the time frame of this whole city, and that's really not that long a time. I mean, it's amazing things, and I really see good things happening in the future. So, the idea of preservation, because I'm president of the Historical Society, it's just something that I cherish so much, and it's a real pleasure to think about it. I take care of the Rainey House now. That was actually the first real preserved structure in this town. Is that right, Wilby?
I think it was.
Yeah. So my goal tonight is to identify a couple of people or families that have been so strategic in this community, invested so much, their hearts and souls, putting projects together that truly have changed this community. They brought life in many sense back to this community because of their confidence in putting money, investing large amounts of money into this community. I think they were the pioneers of really telling other people, it's gonna work, and that was so important, is to build that confidence here before people would really start spending money. And tonight, I'd really like to honor the Willis family. Lee and Kathy Willis have been so strategic. Cornerstone Award And the reason for it, because projects like the Grady Market, the other things that you've done, it really was the cornerstone of the revitalization, the preservation of this community. And while I wish Lee was here, I know he's watching, and I know how proud he is of this place. Your whole family's done so much for this community. We want to thank you. The other individual that I'd like to identify has just done spectacular work in this community. And again, just laid the groundwork in so many areas. And the person I'm talking about is Lynn Wilson Spohr. Her work at the Coombs House Inn, and I keep trying to add up all the other structures that she's rehabilitated, revitalized, preserved, and I still can't keep a count, but somewhere between 10 and 15. So, I mean, it's just amazing what she's done with me. Thank you so much. You have done so much for this community. I just want you to know how much we appreciate it. You know, this lady is just a worldwide preservationist, and you know, to have her select this community is just, it's wonderful.
I have to tell you, this is a complete shock. Shock. But thank you so much, because I have killed myself for this beautiful town.
Thank Trinity Church for the wonderful job that they've done in doing the tour of homes. I mean, it just showcases this community so much and makes people realize what we've got here. And to borrow a page out of the mayor's playbook, it's a lot about community pride. You know, to have the pride of this, the people, or the structures that we've renovated, restored, and preserved is just amazing. So thank you all for being part of it.
I've made sure I've had no wine before this time. Martha, you need to come up here. There is a fourth award that is a brand new award, and it is called the Passion for Preservation Award. And every year we decided, and this is our partners, we have a steering committee at the Trinity Church Tour of Homes Steering Committee. It's a committee you don't want to be on because you have to work really, really hard. But and then we got the city in, and we got the Chamber of Commerce.
Main Street.
Historical Society, because we were having so much fun we didn't want to leave them out. And we all came together on my back porch, and we came up with the new preservation projects that were either commercial or public in the last year, the last calendar year. So, y'all, we made it up. So when we're dead and gone, people will be doing this, and they'll have the rules and everything. And, you know, we just made it up on my back porch, and I took all the papers away from them, and so
we actually voted.
We voted. Oh yeah. I had a big process.
Yep.
It was, and it is great honor for us to present this award, Passion for Preservation Award, Best New Project for 2012. To Historic Holy Family Center, City of Apalachicola.
Commissioner Chick, would you please join me? Man, now this is, thank you.
Oh, thank you. You know, cities, big cities have lots of choices. And sometimes they make good choices, sometimes they make bad choices. But little cities with not much money, for them to fill out the grants and go through the process, and I know they're still going through the process of filling everything out for this grant, is a lot. And then I took people from Tallahassee over there to see it, because they're going to be speaking tomorrow, and they were gobsmacked. They said, this project needs to be seen by everybody. This is an example of a stellar project. And we did this. We the people in our city.
Every time I walk into that building, I'm awed. It is truly a blessing to this community, and I'm just proud to be a part of it.
I agree with the mayor. It is certainly a very worthy project. We have another person who's standing over here, that Betty Webb, who had an awful lot to do with it. She's put in a number of hours, as a lot of the other city employees, and I think it will serve the city well over the years. And we thank you very much. Yes.
If you want to get a chance, we have some more. We'll be announcing it, let's say in about 15 minutes, about 7:15, we'll announce when we pull them.
$10 to win a plein air oyster boat painting. You choose between the two. We have it framed two different ways. And so please come and get them. This is how many we've sold so far. So